Hi, so my name is Brie and I'm going to be instructing you today on the Shine On tutorial. So today we're actually only going to be using three different paint colors, one tint and one shade. So for those colors, they're going to be our primary colors, blue, yellow, red, and then the shade will be black and the tint will be white. Today I will also be using a couple different size brushes. So for that, we're going to use the large, medium, and small brushes. Okay, so how we're going to start off this painting is we're going to start with our sky, and that will be a mixture of blue and white, kind of in a X crisscross pattern. So what I started off with was the blue on there, and then I added the white afterwards. That way we get a little bit of variation with the sky. As you can see, I'm just doing the X back and forth. We're going to do about the first quarter of this canvas, and then afterwards we're gonna move on to the yellow. So go in here, make sure there's no big clumps of that blue and or white, and that they are fairly mixed together. By doing this Xing pattern, you get a little bit more variety in your sky. And then also, if you would like to paint the sides of the canvas, if you have a stretch canvas like I do today, I would recommend that. It'll make it a little bit easier for you guys to hang up. It'll look nicer. So while the paint is wet, I'm going to add a little bit of red into the corners of this painting. The reason why is to give it a little bit of purple, kind of to go with that feel of duskish, and that the sky is changing colors. So as you can see, I'm continuing with that X pattern, and I am doing it on the corners as well, so that way when you guys are walking down the hall or wherever it is that you have this picture hanging, you will be able to see that the red wraps around to make that nice purple glow, almost like the sky is changing. And you can add as much red or as little as you guys like. So I'm doing a little bit, and then I'm continuing that X pattern randomly in a couple spots just to make it look like it flows a little bit better, so it doesn't just randomly stop with the red on the corners. But again, personal preference is red or as blue as you would like. So I'm rinsing off my paintbrush, and then I'm going to dry it. Okay, so now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna have some white. That makes it a little bit easier to blend the colors, so that way we don't go from blue to yellow and get a green. So what I'm doing now is I'm going to be blending in that white and yellow together. And don't worry if you do get a lot of green or you don't like the way it blends, we'll be adding in clouds later, so that can get covered very easily. That's not difficult to get rid of. For us to blend these two colors together is to hold the brush horizontally, so that way it is flat. As you can see, I'm going along the edges, moving the blue and the white together just slightly over the yellow. And then again, I'm doing it with the yellow slightly over the blue. So this creates a slight green, but not too much that we're gonna have a lime green sky. This way they will be blended enough that it looks like the sky has changed colors, but also not too blended that we get a yucky green color for our sky. So once I've gotten the blending to most of my satisfaction, like I said, we're going to be adding in clouds later, so it's totally okay if this isn't something you love where it's blended. However, right now what I'm going to do is go down to about halfway of the painting, and we're going to be adding in this yellow hue. If you want to do something a little bit more muted, you're more than welcome to add white in to the painting. Blending in white with any of these colors will give you a lighter tint, and it'll mute the colors just a little bit, not too much. So as you can see, I'm still doing that horizontal. I'm trying to blend in. There's a spot on the right hand side of my canvas that I'm not over the moon with at the moment. I'm not a huge fan of how it blended in with the colors, so I can tell you for a fact right now I'm going to be putting in a cloud right over there. I'm measuring to about halfway. I put a little dot for myself and a line, that way I know about how far I want to go down on the canvas. Because if I keep painting, next thing you know, the whole canvas will be yellow and we won't have a beautiful ocean. So that little mark there is a reminder. If you guys want to do that, it makes it a little bit easier to keep with the lines parallel as well if you want to sketch it across. And another way to bring color easier if your paint is too thick is to add just a little bit of water. So if you dip it in your water cup, just teeny bit, you don't want your brush dripping wet. But one thing I love about acrylic is that you can turn acrylic paint and make it super watery, almost like watercolors. I'm going to the horizon of where I would like my sky to eventually meet the ocean. And again, I am blending this around the sides of my canvas so that way it wraps all the way around. One trick that I want to show you guys is the masking tape trick. So I have a piece of masking tape and I'm going to be lightly pressing it across the canvas so that way I get a solid straight line, and I'm gonna just go quickly across it with the yellow. And then once you pull it off, it actually will leave you a almost perfect straight line. Just going in and blending in a little bit more with a little bit more yellow, so that way it kind of overtakes where the blue was wet before, and I get less of a green mixture. And as you can see, straight line. Ooh. be taking a scoop of white and blue, and we're going to be actually painting the ocean now. So the same thing with the water, to make it almost like a watercolor. I'm doing that with the blue. I like the way it looks when I do a water scene, and not all the water is identical in color and movement. So what I like to do for water, kind of like when you're at the ocean, it's a little bit darker down near the horizon where it meets. So I will do less water, more paint up top, and then as I go down, it'll blend out a little bit lighter. So a little bit of white paint if you want to add to that bottom, and then more of that dark blue up top. So that can be solid blue. If you even want to add a little black into it, you are definitely allowed to. You guys can even add in red and make it a purple sea. But what I'm doing is I'm adding more of a white to the front, because I know later on that's where we're going to be putting in the rocks. And typically when there's rocks in the water and it's moving, it creates more of a white, like choppy looking water. So I prefer to make it a little bit lighter, and then we'll do the darker out near the horizon. Just a reminder, if you paint the edges of your canvas, it'll wrap around nicely. And so right here, I'm freehanding the ocean part of the horizon. If you guys want to wait a little bit or take a hair dryer and dry that yellow, you guys can definitely do that. But I'm gonna go for it, freehand it. Otherwise, you can do that same masking tape trick once the yellow is dry. Just make sure it's dry. For this portion, I actually fast forwarded it at a 20 times speed, just so that way you guys didn't have to sit around watching me paint the blue ocean. We are only going about 2/3 of the way towards the left of the canvas, so you can leave it blank. It probably looks a little strange, we're not going all the way, but we're going to be adding in a giant cliff later on. If you need to pause the video at this point to catch up, you're more than welcome to. Otherwise, I'm not doing anything special other than adding the blue to the ocean. We gave the sky quite a bit of time to dry. So now we're going to start with the clouds, and like I said before, if there was anywhere that blended that you did not like for instance, I can tell you the blending on the right hand side, I just was not a huge fan of the way I did it. So I'm going to be covering that up with some clouds. So we're going to take our second brush, the medium sized brush, and on here you just want to make sure it's wet. You don't want it too wet, just enough that you put it in the water, dry it off, and then we're gonna do what's called a stippling technique. So for the stippling technique, what you're gonna do is you're going to put your paintbrush in the white paint, and you're gonna dab it onto your plate a couple of times so that way you get off actually a lot of the paint, because you don't want too much paint on that paintbrush. Then you are going to poke the canvas very fast with your paintbrush, and that's how we're gonna get that stippling technique. So in order to make the clouds, you kind of want to make it look like a triangle almost, that it does have that point at the top and then it tapers out on the two sides. So by doing that, it will look like a cloud. And then after you've done a couple of clouds and that paint has dried on those initial clouds, we can then go back, add in a little bit more white to make it more opaque, so that you don't see through it, it's not as translucent anymore, and that'll give actually the clouds their 3D dimension. So as you can see, I keep going back and forth with grabbing some more of that white paint. I'm covering up a couple sections that I wasn't completely over the moon about when I blended initially. Another technique you guys can do as well is blend out the bottom portion of the clouds just a little bit, so that way if they are a teeny bit more translucent, it looks like they were naturally created. We did fast forward this portion just because I do like to paint a lot of clouds, Again, like with the ocean part, if you guys want to pause it, catch up, paint some more clouds, you guys can. Otherwise, feel free to skip over the cloud portion, and then we're going to get going and start it on the cliff once we're done with our clouds. Okay, so now what I was doing on the canvas was just making sure that it was completely dry because we're going to be starting on the cliff portion. So everywhere where it's white, we are going to be painting a brown color. So to make brown, we're going to use one part red, one part yellow, and half part black. So basically what that means is you get a scoop of red, a scoop of yellow, and just a teeny bit of black, because that goes a long way and will definitely darken the color real fast. So as you can see, we have this reddish color, and now I'm adding in the black, and you can see that it is turning into a brown. It was a little red for my liking still, so I did add in a little bit extra of that yellow color at the end. So when making brown, there is no right or wrong. You can add as much of any of those three colors as you want. I recommend doing a darker color for the base for while we're doing the cliff, just because then we can add in a little bit more highlights once we get to the more detailed stage. So here I'm going to go slightly over the horizon, and again, this does not have to be perfect because it is a cliff and rocks are not perfect. And bear in mind, this again is just the beginning shape. We're going to put in a lot more detail afterwards and it will look like a cliff. I know it looks like just a blob right now on the side of your canvas. So as you can see, I did have a little bit of the white section left over. I didn't go far enough on my painting, so I kind of made it up with a little bit of cliff and a little bit of ocean. So I did extend the cliff on the top portion. However, I'm going to use that same blue that we used for the ocean. I'm going to make it up real quick, and I'm actually going to fill in this little portion to the right of this soon-to-be cliff with blue. And because it is an ocean, if you go a little bit darker, as long as you blend it into the color of the ocean that you have next to it, it'll look a-okay. So if anything, it'll look kind of like a shadow. So again, there are no mistakes, just happy accidents that you guys can make, and this is one of them that I did, unfortunately. It's time for a new cup of water. I'll show you guys in a second why. From all of that, it is gross. If you guys are at your house and you want to dump it down the drain, go for it. However, what I'm gonna do is get a new paper towel and some new water. You can always use the same cup. I'm in a basement right now, not next to a sink. So rather than running upstairs, I'm just trading cups. I normally use two cups when I paint and then rinse them both out when I'm done. But if you guys are by a sink, feel free to dump it out and just fill it up with more water. What I'm doing now is I'm taking one part blue, one part yellow, one part white, and we're actually gonna be doing the grass on the top of the cliff. So when you guys do this, it's gonna be the same stippling effect that we did with the clouds, but we're gonna use a bit more paint. We're not gonna water it down this time. We're not gonna go gentle. You want it to cover that entire top portion. So we're gonna do up here. And the one that I did, honestly, is a little bit blue. I didn't add enough yellow in there to make it that bright green that I was hoping for, but I gave it a nice base coat. So what I'm gonna do now is actually, I'm gonna add in a bit more yellow so that way I can have it brighter. So I'm gonna use that same bluish green color that I used before with a little bit of yellow that I'm taking, and then I'm gonna use my small brush, and that is what I'm going to do. So you can see it's a bit lighter, and on the edges, actually, you can stipple it in if you wanna go on the edges and kind of do like a pull up motion almost with your brush. You could make it look like little strands of grass, but because this is so far away, I'm doing more of a stippling, whichever you prefer. If you want to keep the stippling or do it more like grass, it's up to you. And then I am adding in a bit more of that yellowish green, almost like I'm poking it on. And then I'm stippling around it out from there, so that way you do get those pockets of yellowish, light green grass, just like you would if you were to see a field. Not all the grass is the same color. Again, I'm gonna add a little bit more yellow to that new light green, so we're gonna make it even lighter. And I'm gonna add some white just to mute it a teeny bit. And then from there, I'm gonna just kind of go around the edges and where the sun would pick up on it the most. So that front portion of the cliff and then along the main edges. And for this, you can do it in pockets. Again, the same thing. You wanna add that light color in little places, not all over, because again, grass grows randomly all over. Before we start painting the lighthouse, we will be sketching it out with the chalk that we have. If you don't have chalk, you can just use a little bit of white paint and make it look like an A shape. I'm gonna do a simple white structured lighthouse for this one, and we're gonna do just some basic details. I'll show you guys how to get the top just right, so that way it looks like it's glowing with a little yellow light in there. But for right now, what we're gonna do is we're actually going to take some white. It's just kind of like an A, almost, how we're gonna sketch this out. It's not gonna be huge, just over the blue-yellow line where the sky meets. So I'm starting about halfway onto the green part of the cliff, and it's gonna be kind of like a rectangle that tapers off of the top and gets a little bit thinner, but we're not gonna make it like a triangle. So as you can see, it's a little difficult on the yellow almost to see the white. And just as a side note, if you do have chalk and use that to kind of sketch out where you would like your lighthouse to go, or if you do it for another painting and you wanna do it with the cliff, or anything along those lines, once the acrylic paint has dried, actually you can take a damp paper towel or towel cloth, whatever you guys want to use, and just wipe over the painting and the chalk will come right off, like it wasn't even there. So it's like pencil but better for painting. So once you are done with this white portion of the cliff, I'm going to actually add a little bit of black to the edges, which you can see, just I barely touch the black just because it is so harsh in contrast to the white. It'll look like night and day. So if I get just a little bit, go around the edges, kind of line it almost on the left-hand side because that'll be the farther side from the sun. You'll see why shortly when we do put the sun in there. That way it creates a little bit of shadow depth and it'll look like it's an actual circular lighthouse. So I'm adding in a bit more white and I'm going to do the same thing now from the other side. That way you'll get the stark white on the right hand side where the sun is coming from and you'll get the darker shadow from the side that it is not. And it'll help create that illusion that this rectangle all of a sudden is a cylinder and actually a lighthouse. So I'm adding just a bit more of the dark because honestly I think it gives it a little bit better when you see that black like thin line along the lighthouse against the sky. You can really see that it pops out there and how the white blended in prior. Now you can't even tell the difference. Now you can tell that it is no longer a part of the sky and it's its own object. Okay, so the next thing we're gonna do is we're actually gonna make a very muted yellow color. So we're gonna do a little bit of yellow with some white, and we're actually gonna do a square on top of the lighthouse base that we have done so far. And this is gonna be where the light shines through later on. We're gonna add in a little bit more detail once we're done with this. So once you have your square up there, I would make it a little thinner, maybe like a half a centimeter on each side, smaller than what your lighthouse base is so far. So about the width of your small pencil brush would be the perfect size for that. So now when we're done with this, we're actually going to clean off our brush and we are going to be making a gray color. So for this, you're going to want two parts white, one part black. That same gray color that I was using before to do the shadowing. And we're gonna box off the yellow square. So you're gonna do the top, the sides, and the bottom. And you're gonna actually put little lines going vertically on the yellow square. But before we get to that part, we're actually gonna make a triangle that is the width of your yellow and come to a point. It'll be about the same height, but now it'll be a triangle, and then we're gonna kind of turned it into a hat almost, so to speak, kind of like a witch's hat that you would see on Halloween. So you're gonna do the gray part, triangle, and then we're gonna do the flat part of the hat. I'm gonna zoom in on this part just so you guys can see it a little bit better, because you can't really tell when it's this far away, but it'll be a triangle and then a line underneath it. And then we're also going to shape off the light part. So with lighthouses, they have panels of glass. So we're gonna add in that little small detail. There's normally a little catwalk, so to speak, around the lighthouse as well. So we're gonna add that in there on the bottom part. Same way we added that little hat part to the top with the triangle, we're gonna add one now right below the light as well. Okay, so now what you can see is I made a gray color with the black and the white. And so what I did was this brush that I'm using is actually dry. So I'm putting very, very little amounts of paint on it, and I'm gonna drag it across the brown portion of the painting. So by doing this, actually you're creating what looks like the highlights of the crevices that are along the rocks. And I'm gonna do the exact same thing with the black. The only difference is for the black, I'm gonna create a little bit of a shadow since I did go over on the green side where the cliff meets the ocean. So by adding in these dark and light lines, again, we're putting very little paint on the brushes here. You want a dry brush on this one. You don't want it to be wet. You're actually creating a texture that'll look like these are cliffs that have been weathered for years by oceans and storms. Want it to be muted. The black on there is just to accentuate where the rocks are going in, and that lighter color is to highlight the parts that are out and more exposed to the ocean. And then I just want to let you know, this ending part down at the bottom of the rocks, you don't have to make perfect because we will be covering that up actually with a wave in a little bit. Once we get there. But again, that dark color you want to highlight now that you've accentuated the dark portions. You can go in and opposite of the black, add a little bit of that light just to show the depth of the ocean, of the rocks. And now it actually looks like there's a cliff on the ocean. So yeah, as you can see, I keep going back and forth. I am adding little spots that are a little bit lighter that create that three dimension, almost that it is a rock that's actually there. that is one part red, yellow, and black. And then I have one, then I took a little bit left over that, which is the farther color that you can see, added a little bit more yellow and a little bit more, and I added some white actually to that to make it lighter. You'll see why we do that in a minute. So I'm not gonna make any huge rocks on this one. That's just personal preference. If you guys wanna make bigger rocks, make them pointier, jagged, more dull and round, you're more than welcome to. However, I'm gonna make just a few over, one near the beginning of the cliff, and then I'm gonna make them a little bit bigger as we go out, away from it, because that's typically what lighthouses are for, is to warn sailors or those in the ocean that there are rocks nearby or that there's an island, land, something to warn them about. And one of the good things about adding in rocks, especially since we made it a lighter color earlier, it makes it a bit more fun looking when we add in the waves crashing against the cliff. So now I'm cleaning off my brush. I'm actually gonna use that light color. I'm gonna mix in now the yellow and the white. And so what I'm gonna do is I'm actually gonna highlight. Kind of almost like a triangle I'm gonna make on each right-hand side. It's gonna be a little bit lighter. And then same thing even with that small one that you could barely see over on the left-hand side, I'm doing that as well. And then you do want it to be slightly blended in. So I'll zoom in for this part so you guys can see that as well, because there are smaller details. So now what I'm gonna be doing is I'm actually taking a little bit of white and I'm putting that in on the sides of the rocks just to give it that little highlight almost. And because the paint is wet, it is blending very nice, so that way you can't tell that it's a stark white on these brown rocks. It looks more like the sun's hitting them. So now what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be taking that black and I'm going to edge it out the rocks similar to what I did with the white. So except for this will be on the left hand side of each rock, you'll see that the edges are black. However, I am blending it in. So as you can see, I edged them out with the black and then I am slightly blending them in to the brown. That way it does look a little bit more natural. And then I am just touching up a couple of the sides of the rocks so that way they're blended a little bit. So at this time, actually, I am taking a bit of blue and I'm adding quite a bit of water to it. So it's almost like a watercolor. And then what I'm going to be doing is actually, as you can see, it's very liquidy. Adding just a teeny bit more water to it. Now I'm going to take my medium-sized brush, take a little bit of that, and I'm just going to drag it across the water, so that way it gives it some dimension. As you can see, it makes it look like there's movement in the water by doing this. So once you've done this across all of the water, we're actually going to start now making the sun reflection. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a little bit of yellow and some white just to lighten it up. Cool. So you can actually put the lines, the reflection wherever you put the sun. So at first I thought I was going to put it on the right hand side, that's why I was kind of leaning over there, but I decided it would look a little bit nicer in the center, since we are going to be having, I'm not going to make the sun reflection too large, but I am going to keep with it smaller by the horizon and then work its way out to a larger triangle the farther away it gets from the horizon. And we will be putting in the sun in a minute. However, I do like blending it out with a little bit of water, because then it does look a little bit more realistic, like it's blended in with the ocean. So now I'm going to actually take a stronger color yellow, and I'm going to do the exact same thing that I just did, this time with streaky lines of yellow. So now I'm going to take two parts yellow, one part orange, and I'm actually going to make the sun. So I'm going to put it fairly close to the horizon, down near the yellow, for the reason that I made a very small reflection. So the higher it is, the bigger the reflection will be. I am adding a little bit of art of the red to give it some contrast against the yellow. So what I'm going to be doing next is we're going to be adding some of the water detail to where the rocks are. That'll be with white. So what I'm going to be doing is watering down the white so that we have that watercolor consistency. As you can see, I needed a little bit more white because I used quite a bit earlier. And then what we're going to do is we're actually going to edge out the bottom portion of the rocks so it looks like the water's moving around it. And then what you can also do is kind of make a V on the right hand side of the rocks so that it looks like the water is going around. So a sideways V, kind of like that. And then what we're going to be doing actually over here is similar to the stippling that we had done for the clouds as well as the sky. We're going to do the same thing along the cliff on the bottom portion. And this is going to be our crashing wave onto the rocks. So once you've gotten the stippling portion done on the rocks, what we're going to do is we're actually going to create that little wave. So I am using some of the light to show that the water is coming out from the ocean. And then we're going to use a little bit of white and blue and kind of create that wave. So it's going to be more white towards the foam where it's crashing, and then it'll get more blue as we go out away. And another thing that I absolutely love is adding some splatter. So what we're gonna do is take the white, we're gonna add a ridiculous amount of water with your smallest brush and mix it around, so that way if you hold your plate up on an angle, it'll just go flying all over. What you're gonna do then is flick it. So you're gonna take the paintbrush and just go towards the water, and it'll create that ocean spray effect. You can do it by the rocks as well as by the side of the cliff, so that way it looks like it. You can't see it that much on my screen until I zoom it in over here, but so once that is done, we are going to then continue with our wave, blending it out to the blue portion. So as you can see, I do have some blue that I'm blending into it. There's a little bit of a darker blue as well to help give that definition to shade in the wave and how it is crashing along the shore or along the cliff.
Music that they like, and they'll, the first thing they'll
So as you can see, I'm keeping it kind of on a curve, because then it looks a bit more like the water would. And then I'm taking that blue and I'm doing the same thing to darken up the white just a little bit, so it doesn't look like straight white that is coming through the waves. I'm also going to create a small wave on the right hand side, so it's kind of creating like a little bump in the water. I'm going to do the same thing with the stippling effect that we have done previously, and you can do as many of these as you want. I feel like the more that you create, the more it looks like the water is moving. So I did a handful of them throughout, did about two or three of them, and then I did one more pronounced over on the right hand side by where the rocks are. And when you're doing that, you can also make it a little bit lighter on that far left side of the waves. That way it looks like it is actually crashing over on itself. And so what I'm doing here is I'm actually adding a little bit more of that spray that I did before, and then this is the final portion of the painting. So we're gonna add the light coming out from the lighthouse beacon. We're gonna use that same light that we're using for the splatter. And we're gonna do an angle going upwards and an angle going slightly downwards. What we can also do is a darker green, similar to a triangle along grass, so it looks like there's a shadow coming out as well from the lighthouse. Anything else last minute that you guys want to add, you're more than welcome to. I'm going to be adding a door and window as well to the lighthouse. If you want to add a sailboat, if you want to add more waves, more rocks, go for it. This painting's yours, and you can make it however you like. If you guys have any questions or comments in regard to the painting, if you need me to explain something better, please let me know in the comments, or you guys can email me at info@canvasandcraftsbybrie.com. I check my emails all the time. And I hope that you love your shine on painting, and also post those in the comments so that way I can see everyone's great lighthouses. And thank you again for watching, and make sure that you guys live colorfully.